Rev up your engines! I'm going to dispel some myths about what you should put in your car's engine. The last 52 years I've been working on cars, I've seen people put all kinds of strange things in their engine oil in the hope that it'll make the engine last longer. Now, when I was a young mechanic, one of the big things was that STP oil treatment. They called it motor honey. And it was thick like honey. I mean, that stuff, you could sit there with a can and pour it in and leave it there, and half an hour later there's still a little bit dripping out. Now, back in those days, when there were just simple push rod engines, the lubrication systems were easier. They didn't have overhead cams where the oil had to be pumped from the bottom of the engine all the way up to the top before the cam started to get lubrication. They were simpler machines. And when they got old, the metal wasn't as good as it is today. They would wear out faster. They start burning oil and making noises. People would get the STP oil treatment, the really thick stuff. They'd pour a can in. Sometimes as soon as you poured that can in, you'd hear the noise of the engine quiet down quite a bit. Thicker oil, can take spaces up better. And in a case of STP, I believe that it had molybdenum bisulfate, which is a good lubricant for helping lubricate things. So you had an old worn out engine, guys would pour it in and say, hey, look, it's running better, it's quieter. And in the case of old worn out engines, hey, it was no miracle, but it quieted them down. They'd burn a little bit less oil. People would use it. But then, of course, beliefs start happening in people's heads. And sometimes beliefs are counterintuitive to what actually occurs. You'd see people, they would just put the thing in all the time. They'd add this heavy oil all the time because they thought, oh, it's going to prevent wear. Some people today, they will put fuel cleaner in their gas tank every time they fill it up, which is a complete waste of money. Modern engines use lighter oils. They have different metals. They have different designs. You could actually harm the engine by adding a bunch of heavier oil into the stream. I've personally torn down engines in the past. The customer used too heavy of an oil for the engine, and it led to internal damage wear that occurred too quickly that wouldn't have occurred if they would have used the lighter oil. Realize that 90-something percent of the wear on your engine occurs on startup. The oil's on the bottom. You start it up, the oil's got to pump through the system. Modern vehicles, they're designed for lighter oil. If the oil's too heavy, it takes too long for that oil to get up to the top where the cams are, variable valve system, all that stuff. Short period of time, it's running without proper lubrication. You don't want to make it even longer that it doesn't have proper lubrication by putting too heavy of an oil in the engine. This is an oil additive, Lucas, but it's the low viscosity stabilizer. The original Lucas oil stabilizer was much like STP. It was real thick, super thick stuff. Even they realized, hey, you can't do that in a modern engine. So they came up a short time ago with their low viscosity one that sets better with the low viscosity oils that all modern cars use. You didn't maintain it, or you bought it used and the previous owner didn't change the oil enough, you can go and add a low viscosity additive to try to help any problems that it has. But you would be doing the wrong thing if you poured the thick version into that same engine. They weren't designed for a heavy oil. It's not going to do the correct lubrication fast enough, and you could create more problems than you're helping by putting any kind of additive in. Now, another myth I'm going to dispel is, over the years I've seen lots of guys, oh man, I'm going to flush my car's engine oil because the engine oil got dirty, and oh, that'll make it better, it'll clean it all up. Now, I have engine oil flush in a can, but I don't use it very often on any of my customers' cars. If somebody just bought a car, or if, as one of my customers did a couple months ago, brought in a Toyota and they hardly ever changed the oil, it was almost out of oil, I pulled off the valve cover and there was nothing but crud inside, dried up oil residue, then I will use a flush one time to try to get most of that crud out. I've met people that said every time I change my engine oil, first I put some flush in, flush it all out, and then change it, everything's clean. That's not a good idea. That can actually wash some of the stuff that's helping seal the engine. They wear over time, they get a little coatings here and there, and it'll actually run better that way. Realize that when you buy a brand new car, a lot of times, you'll get better gas mileage, got 30, 40, 50,000 miles on it, as things wear and settle in, gets to pretty much its peak efficiency. Think about it, newer engines are all new, everything's tight as they wear, they loosen up a little, and they can actually get a little bit better gas mileage as they age somewhat. And if you would flush your oil every time you changed it, yeah, when you check the oil on the dipstick, hey, it'd be whistle clean. You think, oh, great, it's all clean. No, you don't want to do that. So don't go by that old wives' tale that too dirty, I need to flush everything out. Because all modern cars use what's called detergent oil. And the detergent, what it does, basically, is it keeps the dirt in suspension inside the oil. When I was a young mechanic, a lot of cars used non-detergent oil. And what happens is instead of the dirt flowing with the oil and staying in suspension, it would just settle down to the bottom. There would be sludge everywhere. In my grandfather's day, he was also a mechanic, many winters they spent taking engines apart, cleaning all the sludge out, actually scraping it with scrapers, and then putting the engine back together. Because the oil wasn't detergent oil. It didn't take the dirt and suspension. The dirt just went down and settled all over the place. But all cars use detergent oil. So the detergent in your oil keeps the dirt suspended in the oil, and any larger pieces will get filtered by the oil filter. So if you check your oil and it's looking a little dirty, that's actually a good thing, because having all the dirt suspended in the oil and not sticking on the engine all over the place. So when you change your oil and filter, the dirt goes away with a dirty filter and a dirty oil, and you put new oil in. I've seen everything from oil additives that claim more horsepower, better gas mileage, sometimes both of them together, which of course is physically impossible. If you get more power, you're gonna get worse gas mileage. That's just how it goes. You can't get something for nothing. Now, of course, with modern technology and computers, you can have a car with an engine and transmission design that actually can have more power at certain moments and get better gas mileage at other moments by altering how the vehicle runs. It can change the ignition timing. It can change when the transmission shifts. It can change how much fuel the injector spray in the engine, so it can have a ton of power when you're accelerating. But then when you're just cruising, it goes really efficiently because the computer changes the parameters. They couldn't do that in the past with carburetors, because a carburetor is a carburetor. It's mechanical. It's only work one way. You could adjust it so that it worked better at higher speeds or better at lower speeds, but you couldn't be driving around to change itself. But modern cars can. But that's all done by computers. They only know zeros and ones. That's all a computer knows. It just does it really fast. But it's pure logic. They don't do it by adding anything to your engine oil. Now, another myth about engine oil in cars. Well, you know, in the winter, you're going to use a lighter oil. And in the summer, you're going to use a heavier oil. Modern cars aren't made that way. You get one oil, you use it all year round. Now, if you do live in an insanely cold climate like northern Canada or Alaska or Siberia, the modern cars have such low weight oil, some are like 0W20, they're lightweight oils. You got to use synthetic oil. That's the only way you can get a 0W oil. It has to be synthetic. So you're going to be using the synthetic oil that flows better in cold weather anyway. Generally, your engine and your radiator are designed so they run at the same temperature internally, regardless of what the temperature is outside. You have any modern car? Check it out in the summer versus the winter. Look at your temperature gauge. If it's running correctly, it's generally going to stay in the same position. Once it warms up in the winter, it's going to stay probably around the middle. Same thing in the summer, it's probably going to stay around the middle. And if you had an oil temperature gauge, which most cars don't have anymore, but if you did, you'd see that the oil temperature, once it reaches operating temperature, once you get it started running and driving around a very short period of time, you'd see that the oil temperature is still running about the same temperature, whether it's winter or summer. So the inside of your engine is always running at about the same temperature, summer, winter. Don't waste your time changing oil weights for the summer and winter. You just use the same one in all modern cars. Just make sure you're using the correct oil. Sometimes guys say, oh, I can get this diesel oil real cheap and I'm gonna put it in my gasoline engine too. Don't do that. The oils that are made for diesel engines are specifically designed by engineers for diesel engines. And if you drive a gasoline engine, don't try to save money and buy diesel oil because it's on sale and put it in your gasoline car. And when it comes to switching brands of oil that you use in your car and oil changes, at least here in the United States, all the oils have to meet certain standards to be sold. As you can see, the American Petroleum has labels on it. This is a very good one, SN Plus. Any oil that has it on is perfectly decent oil, but I don't advise switching from one brand to another and back and forth. And the problem is, they're all trade secrets, right? Even Scotty can't find out what's actually in them. I've been to these companies and say, hey, can you show me all that? It says everything's in your oil. They said, no, those are trade secrets, they're trademarked. We don't want anybody to know what they are. So even I don't know what's actually in the things. So when you don't know what's actually in something, even I have a tendency of being somewhat superstitious about it. If I use a certain brand of oil and never have any engine problems with them, guess what? I'm gonna stick to using that same brand. Yes, maybe I'm being superstitious here, but if it works, why argue with success? Since no one's ever gonna tell me or you what's exactly in each oil, I stick to one brand in my cars because, hey, I don't really know what the additives are in this one versus another one, so I just personally stick to that. And yeah, maybe I can buy oil that costs somewhat cheaper that would work just as good, but I mean, if we're talking about $2-3 a quart more for what I'm using, I don't care. I know how many thousands of dollars and what a pain in the rear end it is to put an engine in a car, and for a few bucks here and there, I'll stick with the oil that I've been using for years that I've never had any problems with. And since this is Mechanic Monday, I'll be giving away some very good oil you can put in your car. It's expensive oil, but it's really quality stuff. To have a chance to win, place a clean, non-offensive comment on the YouTube comments below to get a case of this excellent oil. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.